Friends of Reading High Football would like to congratulate Mike Boyd on his induction into the RMHS Athletic Hall of Fame. Reading High class of 1999's Mike Boyd was an outstanding three-sport athlete and captain of the football and basketball teams in his senior year. A winner of 8 varsity letters, he was a 2-time all-league selection in football and a 2-time league all-star in basketball, and in his senior year earned league all-star honors in the javelin. Football was Boyd's best sport. He showed promise from an early age as he helped the Reading Pop Warner A team with a rare league title and an earn a playoff berth, playing alongside a collection of young players who would experience even greater success at the high school varsity level. The 6'2", 180-pound Boyd started the 1997 and 98 seasons at quarterback and was a productive, winning signal caller. But his natural position was safety. A 3-year starter on the defense, Boyd was a defensive general and ferocious hitter, in part due to his natural instincts and timing. Perhaps Boyd's greatest athletic accomplishment at Reading High was being the only sophomore to start on Reading's unbeaten 1996 Division II Super Bowl championship squad. He had a couple of key pass breakups and a pair of eye-opening big hits in the 20-0 shutout of Acton Boxborough in the snow in the championship game. Probably the best defense I've ever seen in our league, period, was the 96 defense. The team was ridiculous. Big, fast, physical, mean, and on top of that, smart, said Reading head football coach John Fiore. And the starting free safety for us was Mike Boyd. After this team started 0-2 in his junior year, Boyd was moved from a split end to quarterback in game 3, where he helped guide the Rockets to an 8-3 Middlesex League co-championship season. Reading suffered a 7-6 loss to the Wakefield Warriors in a late-season defensive clash, a game in which Boyd suffered a back injury that kept him out for the remainder of the year. The loss also knocked Reading out of the postseason play. But Boyd would return to help the Rockets to a Hall of Fame season on the gridiron in 1998, guiding the team to a 10-1 Middlesex League and Division II Super Bowl championship season. Boyd was not the biggest or the fastest player on the football field, but he was smart and had little trouble running the Rockets' multiple-look wing-tee option offense, and he was always composed under center. That coolness under fire allowed Boyd to engineer one of the great all-time comebacks in the history of Reading High football. On Saturday, October the 3rd, at Birch Meadow, the Rockets trailed a talented and title-contending Melrose team 14-7 with under a minute to play. Reading scored with 43 seconds on the clock but missed a 2-point conversion. But the Rockets recovered the onside kick, and after a 31-yard Boyd scramble and a 12-yard pass to Jamie Gath, Andrew Mallett kicked a 29-yard field goal with 3 seconds on the clock to pull out the 16-14 win. Reading next beat Belmont in an early season showdown of league unbeatens. Boyd had an interception in the game to help the Rockets roll to a commanding 17-0 shutout of the Marauders. Reading then faced a big late November matchup with once beaten Wakefield at Landrum Field with a league title and bowl berth on the line. Boyd engineered a late fourth quarter drive, and his 1-yard touchdown run on a quarterback keep with 1:19 left proved the difference in a hard-fought 18-16 win. The wins over Melrose, Belmont, and Wakefield in an extremely tough regular season schedule were the highlights as Reading finished unbeaten in the Middlesex League play and earned a berth in Division II Super Bowl at Boston University. The Rockets dominated Braintree start to finish with a 37-6 win. Boyd earned his second all-league selection in football after the 1998 season. He led the team with 5 interceptions and 4 fumble recoveries and was 4th on the team with 45 tackles. He also threw 5 touchdown passes and rushed for 4 more. In the Summer Carroll Classic, Middlesex League versus Merrimack Valley Conference All-Star football game, Boyd earned defensive MVP honors for the Middlesex League squad. Boyd's second best sport was basketball, where he was a good passer, defender, and mid-range jump shooter. Although the Rockets finished just 6-14 in the 1997-98 season, and he missed nearly half the season with a back injury, Boyd, a junior, was selected on the team's lone rep for the Middlesex League All-Star Game. He finished fifth on the team with 142 points, averaging 10.9 points per game. In his senior year, Boyd helped the Rockets to their best season in hoops in more than a decade. Under the first-year head coach Jeff Nelson, the Rockets finished 14-8 and advanced to the second round of the Division II state tournament, where they lost in the quarterfinals to eventual Division II state champ East Boston. Reading recovered from a 5-4 start by going 10-3 in its remaining 13 games. Along the way, Boyd contributed to some big wins over the likes of Watertown. In the first round of the playoffs, Reading received a tough draw and had to travel to number 6 Gloucester, which was 15-5 and had beaten Reading 2 months prior in the Gloucester Christmas tournament. But behind Boyd's game-high 18 points, Reading reeled in the Fishermen 58-53. Although Reading lost to East Boston in the next round, the game was won for the ages. A tough 64-62 loss that saw the Rockets miss a game-winning three-point shot with 3 seconds on the clock. The Jets went on to win the Division II state championship, and for the second straight season, Boyd was named a Middlesex League All-Star and finished in the top three on the team in scoring with 11 points per game. Boyd was a consistent top three finisher in the javelin his senior year with a throw of 179 feet 6 inches. He placed third at the prestigious Andover Invitational with a throw of 156.6, and he and teammates Tom Morley and Brian McGrath earned a third-place finish in the javelin at the state Class B relays to help Reading win a Class B relay title. He also placed third in the Middlesex League meet and fifth in the Class B meet, helping the Rockets win their fourth straight Class B title. After the season, he earned league All-Star honors. Following graduation, Boyd attended Bentley College, where he continued his football career as a safety and special teams player. Boyd returned to his high school alma mater, coming back to coach the freshmen and then varsity teams as an assistant under head coach John Fiore. But in the mid-20s, Boyd was suddenly diagnosed and unexpectedly with an advanced case of lung cancer. Boyd battled the disease for 4 years. It ultimately claimed his life in July of 2009, and he remained a coach until the very end. The Rockets dedicated the 2009 season to their beloved coach. Prior to each game that season, players and coaches gathered across the 12-yard line in honor of number 12, the number Mike Boyd wore as a member of the Reading High football team. And they wore a number 12 sticker on their helmets, and many wore Boyd's number in athletic tape underneath their game jerseys. The 2009 season was arguably the best in school history, as the Rockets rolled to an undefeated and new school record 13-win season, culminating in a Division II Super Bowl championship over undefeated Natick at Gillette Stadium. Boyd's jersey was proudly hung at Patriots Place on the Wall of Champions in honor of a player who once played as a champion. Today, a plaque in the Reading High locker room honors the memory of Boyd, bearing his name. The number 12, and the poem, Don't Quit. In addition, Reading's Defensive Player of the Year Award is now named the Mike Boyd Award. Boyd's life was tragic, but also triumphant. His grace under pressure, good humor, character, and leadership, and the example he set late in life with his Don't Quit attitude during his battles with the ravages of a terrible disease, represent the most profound lesson sports have to offer. I miss him to this day. He was a terrific kid, said his then head coach, Tom Kasperzak. You never know when you're going to get to play your last game, metaphorically. Play every game like it was your last one. Mike did that every day. He brought with him an energy, humility, and a great sense of humor. He is the epitome of a great high school player. It is with great pride the Reading Athletic Hall of Fame welcomes Mike Boyd into the Hall of Fame class of 2017.